Hello everyone. In this session, we are going to learn about feedback amplifier, its input impedance and output impedance. Learning outcome of this session: at the end of this session, students will be able to analyze the effect of negative feedback on amplifier's input impedance and output impedance. So this is the content of this session. Now let us discuss what is the effect of negative feedback on input impedance of overall negative feedback amplifier. So high input impedance is desirable in a voltage amplifier since it reduces a loading effect on the preceding stage, or it will not load the previous stage of multi-stage amplifier. So high input impedance or resistance is a required feature of a voltage amplifier. So this can be achieved with the use of a negative feedback. So in a voltage series feedback amplifier, the feedback signal voltage VF, so that is out of phase with respect to the input signal VIN, or external applied input voltage source signal VS. Listen once again, in a voltage series feedback amplifier, the feedback signal VF, so that is out of phase with respect to the input signal VIN of the amplifier. So due to this effect, the input effective input for amplifier VIN reduces, and due to that, the input current, effective input current of voltage series feedback amplifier reduces. So hence the effective input resistance, of voltage series feedback amplifier increases. As the input current decreases, the input impedance or input resistance increases. Now this figure shows the equivalent circuit for voltage series feedback amplifier. In this Z in F stands for the input impedance of amplifier with negative feedback, and Z in stands for the input impedance of amplifier without feedback. So now this block diagram shows the input is a voltage signal Vs, and effective input voltage of this amplifier is Vn. Vf stands for output voltage of a feedback circuit, so that is a feedback voltage signal. And the output at the output side of this amplifier, so output voltage Vout is applied to load resistor RL. So output resistance of amplifier is Zout, or impedance is Zout, and the output voltage is applied to output load resistance RL. So considering this block diagram, the feedback factor beta, so that is the ratio of voltage, output voltage to the input voltage. Output voltage of feedback circuit is Vf, the input voltage for a feedback circuit is Vout, that is output of amplifier. So considering this block diagram, now let us justify the effect of negative feedback on input impedance or input resistance of overall voltage series feedback amplifier. So from figure 1 series feedback connection, the input impedance can be determined as follows. So the effective input current of amplifier IN equal to VIN upon ZIN. So that is equal to VS minus VF. So that is divided by ZIN. ZIN stands for the input impedance of amplifier without feedback. So effective input voltage of amplifier is a algebraic sum of Vs and Vf, that is Vs minus Vf. So that is equal to Vs minus beta into Vout. For Vf we can write beta into Vout. So this is divided by Zin. So where Vf, that is equal to beta into Vout. So this is simplified to Vs minus beta into A into Vin, where A stands for voltage gain of amplifier without feedback, A or AV. So Vs, minus beta into AV into Vin, so this is divided by Zin. So Vout, that is equal to A into Vin, or IN multiplied by Zin, so that is equal to Vs minus beta into A into Vin, or Vs equal to, for Vs we can write आई इन इंटू जेड इन प्लस बीटा ए वी और ए इंटू वी इन. सो दैट इज इक्वल टू आई इन इंटू जेड इन प्लस बीटा ए इंटू आई इन इंटू जेड इन. सो आई इन इज इफेक्टिव इनपुट करंट ऑफ एम्पलीफायर एंड जेड इन इज इनपुट इम्पिडेंस ऑफ एम्पलीफायर विदाउट फीडबैक. सो वी इन इक्वल टू आई इन इंटू जेड इन. सो इफेक्टिव इनपुट वोल्टेज ऑफ एम्पलीफायर दैट इज इक्वल टू इफेक्टिव इनपुट करंट मल्टीप्लाइड बाय इनपुट इम्पिडेंस ऑफ एम्पलीफायर विदाउट फीडबैक. सो वी एस अपॉन आई इन सो दैट इज इक्वल टू जेड इन प्लस बीटा ए इंटू जेड इन. सो ओवरऑल इनपुट इम्पिडेंस ऑफ एम्पलीफायर विथ फीडबैक विथ नेगेटिव फीडबैक जेड इन एफ. सो दैट इज इक्वल टू वी एस अपॉन आई इन इनपुट वोल्टेज अपॉन इनपुट करंट दैट इज इक्वल टू जेड इन प्लस बीटा इंटू ए सो मल्टीप्लाइड बाय जेड इन. सो दैट इज इक्वल टू जेड इन इंटू वन प्लस बीटा ए और ए वी. सो ओवरऑल इनपुट इम्पिडेंस ऑफ वोल्टेज सीरीज फीडबैक एम्पलीफायर विथ नेगेटिव फीडबैक इट इज इंक्रीज बाय फैक्टर वन प्लस बीटा ए वी. सो जेड इन एफ दैट इज इक्वल टू जेड इन मल्टीप्लाइड बाय वन प्लस बीटा ए वी. सो इनपुट इम्पिडेंस इज इंक्रीज्ड बाय फैक्टर वन प्लस बीटा ए वी. द इनपुट इम्पिडेंस विद सीरीज फीडबैक इज सीन टू हैव द वैल्यू ऑफ इनपुट इम्पिडेंस विदाउट फीडबैक मल्टीप्लाइड बाय द फैक्टर वन प्लस बीटा ए वी. सो इनपुट इम्पिडेंस विथ वोल्टेज सीरीज फीडबैक इज इंक्रीज्ड बाय द फैक्टर वन प्लस बीटा इंटू ए वी और ए. सो दिस इज एप्लीकेबल टू बोथ वोल्टेज सीरीज एंड करंट सीरीज फीडबैक कॉम्पिग्रेशन. फॉर वोल्टेज सीरीज एम्पलीफायर एंड करंट सीरीज एम्पलीफायर द इनपुट इम्पिडेंस इज इंक्रीज बाय फैक्टर वन प्लस बीटा इंटू ए वी. नाउ वोल्टेज शंट फीडबैक एम्पलीफायर. फॉर वोल्टेज शंट फीडबैक एम्पलीफायर द इफेक्ट ऑफ नेगेटिव फीडबैक ऑन इनपुट इम्पिडेंस. नाउ दिस फिगर शोज द ब्लॉक डायग्राम फॉर वोल्टेज शंट फीडबैक एम्पलीफायर. सो इन दिस द फीडबैक सिग्नल आई एफ इज अप्लाइड इन पैरेलल टू द इनपुट करंट आई एस एंड द आउटपुट वोल्टेज इज अप्लाइड टू लोड रेजिस्टर आर एल. सो फ्रॉम आउटपुट साइड वोल्टेज इज टेकन एंड एट द इनपुट साइड ऑफ एम्पलीफायर द प्रोपोर्शनल करंट इज अप्लाइड इन पैरेलल टू द इनपुट सिग्नल सोर्स करंट आई एस. सो कंसीडरिंग दिस ब्लॉक डायग्राम वी कैन फाइंड आउट the effect of negative feedback on input impedance. So using voltage shunt feedback. So from figure 2 voltage shunt feedback connection. So IS equal to IN plus IF. So input signal source current IS equal to the effective input current IN plus feedback current IF and input impedance can be calculated as Z in F. So input impedance with feedback that is equal to voltage upon current Vin upon IS. So that is equal to Vin upon, for IS we can write IN plus IF. So this is equal to Vin upon IN plus beta into V out. For IF we can write beta into V out, where beta stands for feedback factor. So for feedback circuit the input is output voltage of amplifier and output is feedback current IF. So for IF we can write beta into V out. So this is simplified to, so Vin upon IN divided by IN upon IN plus beta into V out upon IN. So after simplification, so this is equal to Zin upon 1 plus beta into A. So overall input impedance of amplifier with negative feedback Zin F. So it is decreased from Z in without input impedance without feedback by factor 1 plus beta A. So input impedance of amplifier with voltage shunt feedback is reduced by factor 1 plus beta into AV, AV or A. So that is a voltage gain of amplifier without feedback. So the effect of negative feedback, that is voltage shunt feedback, the overall input impedance of amplifier is reduced by factor 1 plus beta AV. Now let us see the effect of negative feedback on output impedance of feedback amplifier. So the low output impedance is a desirable feature for amplifier to drive a lower impedance load. the required feature of amplifier to drive a low resistance output load, the output impedance should be low. So voltage for voltage series playback amplifier. Now let us find out the output impedance that can be obtained as follows. The short circuit input terminals of amplifier, short circuit input signal source, so that input terminals of amplifier is shorted, so that minus Vf, that is playback voltage, is only input voltage at the input side of amplifier, and voltage source Vout, voltage source whose voltage is equal to Vout, is applied at the output of amplifier, so that that causes the output current Iout. So the Iout is drawn from applied source and it flows inside the output side of amplifier. So considering that Vout equal to Iout into Zout, where Zout stands for output impedance or resistance of amplifier without feedback, plus A into Vin. So we can write Iout into Zout minus AV A into Vf, so that is equal to Iout into Zout minus A into beta into Vout. So where Vin is equal to minus Vf, and Vf is nothing but beta into Vout, or Vout plus A into beta Vout. So that is equal to Iout into Zout. Or after simplification, Vout into bracket 1 plus beta A or AV. So that is equal to Iout into Zout. Or we can write ratio of output voltage to output current that is equal to Z out upon 1 plus beta A or AV. So this is nothing but the output impedance of amplifier with feedback. So that is equal to Z out upon 1 plus beta A or beta AV. So output impedance of amplifier with a voltage series feedback is reduced by factor 1 plus beta AV. So this is a required feature for the amplifier. So output impedance is decreased by factor 1 plus beta AV. Similarly, the effect of a negative feedback on output impedance of current series feedback amplifier. In current series feedback amplifier, now this figure shows the block diagram for current series feedback amplifier. So in this output quantity taken, sampled, is a current and it is paid back to the input side of amplifier. So the output quantity taken is a current, that is series connection is used, and the signal proportional to output quantity, that is the voltage signal, it is applied in series with the input signal Vs or Vin. So this is the current series feedback amplifier. Now let us find out the effect of negative feedback on output impedance of this current series feedback amplifier. So from this block diagram of current series feedback amplifier, the output impedance with current series feedback can be obtained by disconnecting load RL, by disconnecting output load RL, and apply a signal voltage V to the output with the input signal source voltage Vs shorted out. And taking the ratio of voltage to current gives the output impedance. So current I equal to voltage V upon Z out, so that is minus A into Vin. So that is equal to V upon Z out minus A into Vf. So this is equal to V upon Z out minus A into beta into I out, where Vin equal to Vf, that is equal to beta into I out. Because input for the feedback circuit is a current, output current, and output is a voltage, Vf. So output impedance Z out multiplied by 1 plus beta A multiplied by I, that is equal to V. So here output current of amplifier I out equal to I. So output impedance of this amplifier with negative feedback designated as Z out F. So that is equal to V upon I, voltage upon current, that is equal to Z out multiplied by 1 plus beta AV, where Z out is output impedance without feedback and Z out F is output impedance with feedback. So that is equal to Z out multiplied by 1 plus beta A. So output impedance of amplifier, current series feedback amplifier, is increased by factor 1 plus beta AV. Now student can pause video here and think over this question, try to answer this question. Shunt feedback connection tends to decrease the input impedance of amplifier. Why? The answer is, this is because the current drawn from input signal source is increased by the amount equal to the feedback current IF. So the effective input impedance of the amplifier decreases. As the effective input current increases, the effective input impedance decreases. This is a reference. Thank you.